Well, a very good evening, everyone. Welcome to the SSE Arena in Belfast for this very special game, the Hockey Can't Stop Tour, supporting Ukrainian hockey dream. It is the Belfast Giants All-Stars taking on the Dnipro Kherson in Belfast this evening. There are lots of ways that you can support the cause tonight, this evening, ladies and gentlemen, and you'll be a winner as well, starting with our 50-50 draw. It is happening, the 50-50 lottery, for your chance to win half of that prize pot. Make sure you pick up your tickets and you get them from the sellers all around the concourse. Go grab those tickets for your chance to win half of the final jackpot at the end of tonight's game. Also, we have that very special set of Hockey Can't Stop jerseys tonight. We're giving this all away, all of those Belfast Giants All-Star jerseys on shirt on the back tonight. So all proceeds, of course, going to the Ukrainian hockey dream. So make sure you grab your ticket to get that little piece of world history. The only way you get your hands on all those jerseys in our shirt on the back raffle. Or you can take part in the Giants USC secret raffle. The secret Giants auction is on right now. That jersey auction on the bridge. Go check out the Giants USC desk for their silent jersey auction. You can see the game worn jerseys on the big screen. Giving each one of those, you're going to finish your bids. We'll reveal the winners during the third period this evening on the big screen. That's the way you get your hands on the jerseys this evening. And of course, don't forget, we want strobe light lighting in use all throughout tonight's game, but particularly during the team's introductions onto the ice tonight. So please note, strobe light lighting in use during tonight's introductions. During tonight's Hockey Can't Stop game, of course, here above the 12th minute of play, we welcome you to join us in remembering the Giants legend that was Ray Squata, with minutes long. that true giant on and off the ice. He'll forever be remembered by our club and the fans. He's joined in with that in the 12th minute of tonight's game. John, thank you, Teal Army. By purchasing a ticket to tonight's game, you're helping make a massive difference. If you'd like to make an additional contribution, get yourself online. There is the website and the QR code on the big screen. You can donate to Ukrainian Hockey Dream, BelfastGiants.com/donate. Thank you. Okay, let's have a look at the lineups for our team this evening, starting with the officials on the lines, Vitas Lukasiewicz and James Nelson, and the referee in charge of tonight's game, Andy Dalton. Now let's have a look at the lineups for the team, starting with Dnipro Kherson tonight. Here's Yuri with tonight's lineup.
Number 40, Maxim Sluj. Number 21, Nazar Sushar. Number 80, Artem Portnov. Number 9, Nikita Lesnikov. Number 24, Ruslan Boyko. Number 71, Mavida Vasiliev. Number 19, Ivan Gorbunov. Number 91, Bogdan Bakov. Number 96, Kirill Bondarenko. Number 11, Danilo Tyshchenko. Number 92, Dmytro Pobereza. Number 87, Artem Zolotarev. Number 8, Mykola Kolov. Number 30, Sergei Stetsula. Number 55, Ilya Shcherbak. Number 28, Mikhail Zura. Number 78, Arsen Olin. Number 86, Anatoly Rebuka.
Thank you, Yuri. That is tonight's lineup for Dnipro Kherson. Now let's have a look at the lineup for the Belfast Giants All-Stars tonight. This is how they shape up this evening. Number 6, Jeff Ball. Number 7, Mor Garside. Number 8, Steve Saviano. Number 10, Scott Conway. Number 12, Grant Cooper. Number 16, J.J. Pickenich. Number 21, Kel Beattie. Number 23, Paul Swindlehurst. Number 25, Tim Cook. Number 26, Mark Cooper. Number 35, Andrew Dixon. Number 39, Petr Cech. Number 41, George Awana. Number 42, Guy Bast. Number 47, Adam Keith. Number 55, Jonathan Boxell. Number 64, David Goodwin. Number 70, Matt McLeod. Number 72, Darryl Lloyd. 86 is Max Stewart. 89, Kieran Long. And number 91, Henrik Eriksson. That's the lineup tonight for your Belfast Giants All-Stars.
Let's get down.
by welcoming our friends from the Ukraine to this very important event. Recognize how the Belfast. Over the last 20 years, we have experienced many people putting their hand out to help us when we needed it most. Tonight, we're delighted to not only pay some of that back, but also to pay it forward. Tonight is about celebrating the impact hockey can make, the friendships formed, the respect and solidarity we share with the international hockey family. Tonight, we are particularly supporting the Ukrainian hockey dream in their efforts to support and sustain Ukrainian hockey during the war and beyond. All the proceeds from tonight's ticket sales are going to support their endeavors. In the spirit of celebration this evening, I also need to applaud this year's Belfast Giants. In case you didn't know, they're the first team to win 3 Elite League titles in a row, 6 in total. And they've just achieved the treble. So finally, before we get this underway, I want to thank each and every one of you fans coming out to support tonight's event. For one night only, it is fine to support both teams on our ice. Support them all, enjoy tonight's game, and thank you very much for coming.
Thank you, Martin. Okay, then, as Martin mentioned, of course, the weekend, the Giants were champions once again for the third time this season, lifting that trophy, the 2022 Viaplay Elite League playoffs. So let's turn our attention to the bridge end of the arena. There's another banner going into the rafters. Giants fans, get on your feet as we raise the 2022-2023 Viaplay Elite Ice Hockey League playoff championship banner. Let's hear it one more time for your 2022-2023 Viaplay Elite League playoff champions, your Stedelijk Belfast Giants. Thank you so much for your support all season long. But we've also another very special treat in store before tonight's big game gets underway. We're delighted to have a very special guest with us tonight performing his iconic song, Belfast City. Please welcome Ryan McMullen!
I'm on my way, leaving West LA at sunrise. Time's been great. I kinda wish that I could stay for a little while longer. I've gotta go, but I want you to know I'll be back again. I'm going home to the people I love, where I was born and raised, where the streets and their history to your right. Now I can't sleep, but I can tell you honestly, it's fine. 'Cause I've been dreaming, and it has got me feeling a little high, but that's alright. But oh, how the times have changed. I know it rains, but it's always pretty. Back to the friends that I can't take with me. We'll have a night out in Belfast City, alright. We'll have a night out in Belfast City, whoa.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Ryan McMullen! Giant thank you to him for supporting tonight's event. Now, if everyone could please be upstanding for the national anthem of Ukraine. Okay, thank you so much, Belfast. Now, if both captains could please make their way to centre ice to get tonight's game started, the CEO of Belfast Harbour...
Privet! Hello! Dobre vai cheer! Good evening from beautiful SSE Arena in Belfast, Northern Ireland.
from, you know, we've only got a small group of guys, and Laura and Kelly, Steve, myself, and all the guys behind the Belfast Giants off-ice coaching side of things, and all the players this year absolutely deserve the accolades and every single accolade coming their way this year. We'll talk about it throughout the show, no doubt, but tonight's not just about them, it's about Ukraine, it's about the Belfast Giants, and it's about supporting such a brilliant charity.
Dnipro Kherson, they come in here, they want to have a good game, they know they're up against some members of the Elite League title-holding Belfast Giants, but special guest, we mentioned Darryl Lloyd. How about the starting goalkeeper tonight, number 39, you might know him as a pretty good football goalie, Petr Cech,
I picked him up at the airport this morning, a nicer guy you couldn't meet, an absolute gentleman. You know, he's really looking forward to coming in here. We're number 39, as you say, his hero, Dominic Hasek, and I know he's really looking forward to playing tonight.
Pitter-patter, let's get at her, we're underway. The Giants in teal, of course, Dnipro Kherson in the white with the blue trim, and straight away it's Pope Rajai back to the player coach, Vasiliev, and Vasiliev will get it quickly ahead to Tyschenko. Tyschenko, long range shot, so the first touch for Petr Cech. Bit of a rebound, but it's under control. Also interesting to see Mark Garside, who's played defense for the last 7 or 8 years, his former position as center, he took the opening face-off.
He took the opening face-off between Adam Keefe and Darryl Lloyd, three guys that had that trio together over a number of years in Belfast between 2011, 2014, and 15, and I knew they had a lot of success. That was a grind line, and you knew exactly what you were going to get when they were on the ice.
A little bit of a giveaway now, and it will be Swindlehurst, who is now a policeman, of course, but a former Giant, former Team GB defenseman, and Swindlehurst will dump the puck in, but changes being made by Bondarenko and company is wheeling back his former Giant back again as part of the All-Star squad, Tim Cook.
Yeah, great to see Paul Swindlehurst back on the ice again at the SSC Arena. He played 137 games for the Stenline Belfast Giants. 5 goals, 11 assists for 16 points over 3 seasons, and just an absolute top lad. You know, he's used to patrolling the streets in Manchester now. He's patrolling the blue line tonight.
Keep your head up, Wins. Swinney's out there. Quick shot off the face-off, and another former Giant back into the fray is Steve Saviano. And Steve Saviano, of course, spent plenty of time in the Swedish Hockey League and the Finnish Liga. Saviano throws it in front, and Maxim Soljutin, who gets the start for Kherson, makes his stop. Here's Cooper. Cooper trying to go back door. And wearing number 55 is Jonathan Boxall, also a former Giant who's made the trek back from Massachusetts. And Jonathan Boxall loves to wear the teal, and he could not turn down the invitation.
Oh, and he absolutely loves it here. To be honest, with the conversation that took place to make the phone call to say if he wanted to come back, and we told him about the game, we didn't even have to ask him. He says, tell me when I've got to be there. And we know he loves Belfast, so not a surprise to see Boxy here again.
Sehelorotsev with the drop pass, and the shot comes in off the stick of Olenek, and Petr Cech, good rebound control there from the big goalie from Czechia.
And you know, obviously he's used to, you know, looking after his angles, playing goalkeeper for Chelsea. You know, I was looking at his accolades today, 4 league titles in the Premiership, 5 FA Cups, 1 Champions League, he's done it all. I mean, absolutely unbelievable. I know he played for Chelsea and that other lot in North Belfast, North London. But obviously, you know, great to see him here in Belfast.
McLeod trying to get the puck out front to Max Stewart. Max Stewart's dad, Rob Stewart, is the head coach tonight. Of course, Stewie's number is part of the Legends section in behind Petr Cech there. The likes of Colin Shields, Shane Johnson, Todd Kilman, all in behind on the bridge there. Here's Bast. Bast turns the puck over, trying to wheel out front. There is Rivuka. Rivuka, hard angle shot. Maybe thought that Cech was going to come off his post, but it hits the outside of the iron, and away comes Eriksson. Eriksson to McLeod. McLeod finds a little bit of a lane, trying to get the puck out front to Eriksson, but good sticks there as Lesnikov had a stick in the lane. Tyschenko will backhand it in.
Yeah, again, it's been a nervy start for both sides, and you know, when you the face-off's delayed by a little bit of music and obviously a banner raising as well, it's going to take a little bit of time to get back into the swing of things.
Adam Keefe losing an edge there, and Adam Keefe, we know that he was
I don't
captain.
Know about losing the edge there. I think he slipped.
I'm trying to be kind to Kiefer, because it's you and I up here, we can't criticize. Adam Keefe out front, and Lloyd trying to get a piece of that. They were in their heyday trying to do that time and time again, winning a board battle, get the puck out to the net front presence. Here's Lloyd, dumps it back into the corner former captain Adam Keefe, now a legendary coach, and a play ahead to Poprzej. Poprzej in all alone. Oh, what a stop by Petrček on Dmytro Poprzej.
Great play down the middle. Lovely pass through the seam, and Czech coming up with a huge save, his toughest of the game in the opening 3.5 minutes.
Pretty focused there, as Poprzej had plenty of time to think about what he wanted to do. Here's Portnoy. Portnoy, long-range shot that was tipped by Bondarenko, and up and over the blocker side of Petrček. Interesting to know Petrček uses the blocker on the left hand, which is probably about 80% of elite-level goalies catch with the left, so maybe the Dnipro Kherson forwards are going to have to think about that, trying to pick a corner.
I had to think about it as well. I didn't realize that this morning. I was watching him in the morning skate and thought he looked really good, and he started positively as well.
Setsura into the corner. Boxed out, but here's a chance, walking out front and turning and firing. Good looking shot by Sedlarodsev. And once again, Petrček using that size at 6'6", making himself big even when he's down. Walking out front again is Sedlarodsev. Well, he's turned back on that occasion by Cook Conway. The Elite League Player of the Year gets it ahead to the captain, Goodwin. Goodwin out wide to Pickens. Pickens threw it back in front. Maybe one pass too many as Sedlarodsev will come back and intercept.
JJ Pickens, Scott Conway, and David Gubin on the ice again. And we had so much success last year with that trio, and it's great to see JJ back out again. He missed the end of the Norwegian season because of injury, so great to see him back out.
Goodwin to Pickens to Conway, rebound out front, Saviano, and it's nearly tucked home by Giants assistant coach George Iwata, a former captain, a legendary player, now one of the assistant coaches with the Belfast Giants, and a giveaway in front. Oh, up and over the bar. Scherbak trying to go top corner. As he looked up and saw the glove hand of Petrček flashing. Here's Grant Cooper. Cooper in behind to Jeff Baum. Baum out of Colleyville, Texas to Mark Cooper. Off the skate of Grant Cooper. No relation. Here's Saviano. Saviano trying to get it out front, but it's Lesnikov getting in the way. Well, a dangerous move by Lesnikov, but he had the confidence to try and pull that off, but he's intercepted by Baum.
Yeah, there's a chance there again for Grant Cooper and Mark Cooper, but just couldn't combine properly. Here comes Saviano again.
Here's Cooper. Cooper with his shot and a good looking stop by Maxim Siljutin. Out front against Saviano. Backdoor play, and Grant Cooper will slot it home. And we're all around the goal mouth, and Siljutin couldn't get back to his post. Cooper makes it 1-0 Giants All-Stars.
Grant Cooper, lovely tic-tac-toe move between Mark Cooper, Saviano, and Grant Cooper, and all they had to do was tap it home. The goaltender started really strongly for Dnipro, but a lovely play from three experienced pros to get the chance, their first goal of the night.
Not much that Siljutin can do when those three guys decide to move the puck around. You got the goalie moving, and Grant Cooper, treble-winning Grant Cooper, slots it home. Started his season off the lower level of the NIHL with Leeds and has been an instant fit in teal.
He started off in Belfast really, really well. I mean, he missed the last couple of weeks of the season with an injury. The regular season, but he ended up coming back for the playoffs and playing his part for the playoff championship as well. So great to see him back out there.
Eriksson to McLeod. McLeod with the shot up and over the crossbar, so Mark Cooper and Saviano draw assists on the opening goal of this one. Poprzej calling for it. Poprzej, long-range shot. It actually came off the stick of Kel Beattie and goes wide. Here's Eriksson. He wasn't sure where it was, but he swooped to the backhand and took that pass nicely. Here is Eriksson, product of Sweden. Throws in front, tapped home, Mac Stewart. 2-0 Giants. Max Stewart slots it home.
We talk about just going to the net. We know it's obviously a charity game here tonight, but that's great for Max Stewart's confidence as well. Lovely dipsy doodle around the outside by Eriksson. He's got that in his locker. A lot of skill from the Swede, and a tap home for Max Stewart and his Giants. All-Star Team 2, Dnipro 0.
Go to the net and good things happen, and Max Stewart will make it 2-0 on the lovely feed from Henrik Eriksson. Henrik Eriksson had started his season off in Lillehammer. 14 goals, 16 assists, came over to the Giants, and again, another good fit, another in-season acquisition by Adam Keefe and the coaching staff.
Yeah, we made quite a few changes this year. I think it was 7 in total from the lineup that we started with But these things, it's the business. They sometimes they have to take place. And you can see from the banners hanging up on the east end, that was an important move and a fruitful move.
Here's Adam Keefe. You know the faithful here at SSE Arena would love to see the coach slot one home, but Keefe puts it towards the goal as Daryl Lloyd was calling for the pass.
I'm just wondering what the Adam Keefe on the bench would say about the player making that type of move and just throwing it towards the net.
He might bench himself.
It's great. You know what? You can see this crowd in here on a Wednesday evening in Belfast. It's fantastic. And we talked about this before coming on air, Murph. It's every single penny that's raised tonight from ticket sales is going to the charity that has been the Hockey Dreams in Ukraine. And it's absolutely fantastic. The Odyssey Trust are able to support that.
Olenek throws it out front. Swindlehurst will intercept. That's a great point. You can go to BelfastGiants.com/donate. To help the Hockey Can't Stop Tour. Donate now if you can, and anything helps, whether it's a few pounds, a few dollars, a few euros, wherever you're watching from. Here's Olenek. Arsene Olenek, nice little move by Olenek. Had to be careful there. Conway came in there with a stick. Here's Vasiliev. Vasiliev, long-range shot. He's the player coach, the captain this evening, Vasiliev. Pikinich gives the puck away to Ravuka. Ravuka, just 17 years of age, wearing that full cage, trying to get it out front. And you can see there, Sherbach is just 16 years old, number 55. So some of the players wearing the full cages are teenagers. Simon Kitchen has shoes older than Ilya Sherbach.
You're not wrong, actually. You're not wrong.
Here's George Iwata. George Iwata swings it out wide to Mark Cooper. And at the 12-minute mark, we celebrate the life of former Giant, former NHLer, Ray Sawada.
Razor was an important part of our team that year. He was here, a solid, solid player, an even better person. Very, very, very good friend of Adam Keefe. He was here at the time as well. Daryl Lloyd was here. You know, it's heartbreaking to think that Ray's no longer with us, and his family and two kids are unfortunately never going to see their father again.
In our thoughts, their entire family, and such is the measure of this organization. The number 12 sticker, the number he wore with such distinction in teal, was the number 12 was added to the playoff winning title trophy. And our heart goes out to the Sawada family. What a classy moment there at the 12-minute mark to celebrate the life of Ray Sawada, who unfortunately passed away last week while playing in a recce hockey game. Former NHLer, a fireman, and as you said, as good a player as he was, an even better person. Here's Cooper. Mark Cooper loses a stick. He's going to have to show Petrček some football skills now. Failed miserably as Bondarenko stripped him. You can forgive him. He's a better hockey player than a soccer player, perhaps. Here's McLeod. McLeod gets his pocket picked by Dvornik. Dvornik swings it out wide, and Seheleratsev. Seheleratsev trying to put it back out front, but Jeff Bombs, he's done all season long, a good defensive line for the Giants All-Stars. Here's Seheleratsev, and again, right on cue, Baum takes the perfect defensive line, doesn't take a penalty, just plays the man, takes the puck. Bast, one of the top offensive defensemen in the entire Elite League, wins the puck to Stewart. Here's Eriksson trying to get it to Baum. Baum, I'm not sure if he's the first Giant out of Colleyville, Texas, but he has to be one of the first from Texas to wear teal.
He's the first person from Texas to wear teal for sure, And what an important player he'd been for Belfast this year, especially in the last couple of weeks of the season. He scored the championship-winning goal against the Guildford Flames in the 6-1 victory on the 1st of April. And then he came up big with a huge goal last Sunday, against the Cardiff Devils with the first goal of the game to get the Giants back to tied 1-1.
And McLeod and Eriksson with a little bit of showtime on that last sequence forward. I mean, the skill coming out here in this fun but important evening at SSC Arena. And it's nice to see McLeod, both of McLeod's brothers play in the NHL, such as the pedigree of number 70 in teal.
Well, I was speaking to Matty. He's flying home tomorrow morning. He was due to fly home today, I believe. He wanted to stay the extra day to play in this game. Flies home tomorrow morning. Flies to Edmonton on Friday, to watch the Edmonton Oilers again. His brother's playing for the Oilers. And then I think he's going to New Jersey to watch his other brother play for the Devils.
And his brother Mike in New Jersey, his brother Ryan, an Edmonton Oiler. Sherbach, this is the 16-year-old. He had 8 goals for Kherson this season. Sherbach walks in, and well, it's tapped home. Sherbach to the back post. Olenek was in front. Great skills from the 16-year-old. Good net present from the 19-year-old Olenek, and Kherson are on the board.
What a goal. A kid come off a wall, and okay, you know, you certainly don't want to be doing that in a competitive game. Show great skill around the outside of the defenseman, cut right across the net. You go to the net, you get rewarded. 16 years of age, coming up with a big goal in front of a big crowd in Belfast.
Ilya Sherbach, the youngest player in the game, will score. A couple of defensemen there, Kieran Long, maybe perhaps just didn't want to play the body. And on the back post, everyone was worried about Olenek, and just walking in is Sherbach.
I'd have nailed him. you want to step up. But as you say, I mean, the kids that are coming over here, the guys that are coming over from Ukraine, you certainly don't want anybody getting hurt at this stage.
Popozhai out front, and on the back post was Tyschenko. And Tyschenko, he fanned on it, came off the heel of his stick. Adam Keefe didn't win the puck on the wall. Bondarenko will keep it in for Kherson. Gets his pocket picked by Kieran Long now. Kieran Long perhaps not happy with his play on Sherbach coming off that half wall a moment ago. Tyschenko. Poprzej goes out wide to Kelbeedy. Back to the point now. Mishnikov. Pankov. Bogdan Pankov keeps the puck deep for Ravuka. Ravuka couldn't get away from Garside. Back out front, and it's going to be Sahelarodsev. Sahelarodsev gets his pocket picked, and he recovers nicely against a dangerous customer in J.J. Pikanich. Here's Bondarenko. Bondarenko plays it to Lisnikov. Lisnikov, long-range shot, bounces down. Sahelarodsev had to glove that down. But at that occasion, Czech had hugged up against the post.
Yeah, Sahelarodsev's done really, really well there. Great skill from him. You know, get the puck thrown towards the net again. But, you know, he's playing a lot of minutes out there so far. And both teams are keeping the shift short in the opening first period. There's going to be some sore legs tomorrow morning.
Boyko stopped on that occasion by Petr Cech. Conway, everyone wanted him to shoot. He wanted to find his former linemate from last season, J.J. Pikanich. Pikanich gets his pocket picked by Setsura. Setsura gives it away to Cook. Cook chips it back up the half wall, and here is current Giants captain, David Goodwin. Lifted 3 trophies this season. Former Finnish Liga standout. Played NCAA hockey at Penn State as well. Here's Conway. Conway to Pikanich. And they whip it around here. Conway trying to get to the bumper position. Almost looks like a power play. It's going to drift back to the point. Kept in by J.J. Pikanich and intercepted by Dvornik. And stepping up nicely there to intercept that and send it forward was Boxall. Conway. Cross ice. Long range, low percentage pass. Picked off by Ravuka. Ravuka. Away from George Iwata. Iwata puts a stick on Ravuka. Ravuka right back out into the middle of the ice, and it's Olenek. Olenek poke checked by Boxall. Ravuka and his stiff lifted by Grant Cooper. Grant Cooper and Max Stewart on the board for Belfast. Ilya Sherbach for Kherson. 2-1 Giants All-Stars with 6 minutes to go in the first period. It's gone by in the blink of an eye.
It really has. I mean, some really great skill there by Olenek. And there's a chance here again.
Sura, well, good poke check by Petr Cech. And Ravuk on the rebound sends it wide. Here's Olenek. Back to the point. Here's the player coach, Vasiliev. Just puts the puck into the corner. Ravuka plays it back to Vasiliev. Vasiliev with that high leg kick. Shouldered away by Petr Cech. Jeff Baum. Mark Cooper. Cooper with an assist on the opening goal. It's the long loping strides going. Dropped it back to Baum. It's picked up by Saviano. Saviano to Grant Cooper. Out front, wide open was Terrell Lloyd. try to just give that a little flip, and Silutin says, not on my watch.
I think it was actually Gabe Bast. Yeah, it was Gabe Bast. He flicked it towards the top corner, but goaltender coming up with a huge save. Do you know what? I'm really enjoying this. I think
it's absolutely brilliant. I thought it was Darryl Lloyd, because if that was Gabe Bast, usually it's under the bar. That looked like Darryl Lloyd's hands to me.
You know, let's just say there's been a few of the boys have been celebrating a little bit too hard this week, but it is fantastic that they've made the effort and come out here this evening.
Bogdan Pankov, going to go inside out on Baum. Yeah, if you're tuning in and you're not sure about the Elite League, the Giants on Sunday won their first playoff title since 2010, and certainly some of the players have enjoyed themselves since that point. A big win over the Cardiff Devils, who had won three playoffs in a row. So it was a big moment for the Giants. They completed the treble. They won the Challenge Cup, the league, and, of course, the playoffs. Here's McLeod. McLeod walks in. McLeod with a chance, and Maxim Silutin with a big stop, but Eriksson will pounce. Eriksson throws it up front. Wow! Eriksson and company putting on a bit of a skills competition at times. 3-1 Giants All-Stars.
Matt McLeod coming up with a big goal there, and again Eriksson showing his skill and just taking his time out behind the net of the goaltender. Got his head up, had a look outside, and coming down Main Street's Matt McLeod to put it home. That's two goals from that line here so far tonight. Max Stewart had a really good look at that one from behind the net as well, and it's now 3-1.
Couple of assists from Eriksson. You mentioned it there, it's hard to comprehend the skill when you're playing in a system in a league game or in a championship final, but we're really seeing some nice puck movement and some nice pinpoint passes from the Swedish player Eriksson.
It's just fantastic. You know what? I'm just sort of thinking about watching the game here at the SSC Arena for the first time in a long time, where I'm not stressed.
Exactly.
Do you know what I mean? Every time the Giants have stepped out there over the last number of years, you sort of just want them to win, and tonight it doesn't matter about that. But it's just great to see that, again, everybody's enjoying themselves, and even Adam Keefe, as I say, I think that's about a 15-second shift, but we'll not give him too much hassle on that.
The old adage when you and I were playing the Irish Ice Hockey League, up, down, and off. Up, down, and off.
Oh, dear.
I mean, Adam Keefe is a warrior. The first time I saw Adam Keefe, he blocked a shot with his neck when he was the captain of the Giants.
Sounds about right.
And I thought, this guy's never going to play hockey again. And he got right back up and continued on the penalty kill. So that's when I knew Adam Keefe was made of tough stuff.
Well, he's the most successful coach that the Belfast Giants have ever had. He's, it's now 13 years that he's been in the city. And he's married here. He's got a young daughter. And he's another child on the way. Very shortly, here's a chance.
Here's Conway. Conway walks it. Oh, what a glove save. Goodwin trying to pick top corner, and Silutin comes across. And give the 21-year-old Ukrainian netminder credit. He's made some big stops. Portnoy gives the puck away to Pikanich. It's 3-1 Giants All-Stars, but it could be 4 or 5 if it weren't for Maxim Silutin. Goodwin trying to go up and over the diminutive 5'9" netminder. Not a big goalkeeper. Awada gives it away. Awada to Tyschenko. Tyschenko with a little head fake. George Awada stay with him, stick on stick. Back to the point. Here's Pankov. Pankov with a shot turned aside by Petr Cech. Inside, 3 minutes remaining in the opening stanza. Hope you're enjoying this. We reiterate, if you can spare a dollar, if you can spare 10, BelfastGiants.com/donate. In support of the great cause this evening. Out front, Boxall. It's the Hockey Can't Stop Tour, and of course you can help the Ukraine Hockey Dreams Fund. Here's a chance out front, trying to go up high on that occasion with Saviano. Saviano's family's here, his kids were out in warm-up. It's a family affair as well.
They were out in warm-up, they were on the ice this morning. His young son came over to me, and he watches the games at home, and he says, can you talk about my goal? Can you talk about my play? And I had to commentate on the goal going down Main Street, so young Louis has had the special treatment this weekend for sure.
Here's Jeff Baum. His dad flew over from Texas, was in Nottingham for the playoff final, wearing his Stetson. Always has the cowboy hat on. Long range shot from Bondarenko goes wide. Bast up the middle, reworked on for Cooper. Cooper with a nice little back pass, looking for Grant Cooper. But it's Lesnikov. Lesnikov gets his pocket picked by Bast. Bast out front. Mark Cooper, good back pressure there from Tsitsura. And now Lisnikov ahead. Sahilaratsev, and another good poke check, and waving at the rebound there was Tsitsura. As they nearly closed the gap, but a good poke check there by Petr Cech. Here comes Eriksson back the other way. Eriksson with a little stutter step. Eriksson showing that skill I was talking about. Max Stewart stopped by Siljutin. As now, Bast will send it cross ice. Max Stewart played for GB's under-20s this season. McLeod looking for his second. Good stick-on-stick play by Lisnikov. Trying to go off the apron of the net. They give it away as Dvornik almost got too fancy trying to stick handle out from behind the goal. Here's Bast. Bast with a shot. Right pad saved by Maxim Siljutin, who had a 1.37 goals against average for Kherson this season. So he's the real deal between the pipes.
Yeah, he's doing really well. I mean, you take into consideration, you know, 11 or 12 of these guys have played professional hockey for the best team in the IHL this season. And he's done really, really well.
Sahilaratsev drops it. Dvornik. They whip it around. The captain, Vasiliev, sends it through the goal mouth and out the other side. Portnoy back into the corner. Sahilaratsev, A-frames, protects the puck against the youngster Kelbedi. 15 seconds remaining, 3-1 Giants All-Stars in what has been an entertaining first period as Dvornik trying to tip that pass, check, and check just shuts the door.
He's really impressed me. You know, obviously coming from football where he was ultra successful, and coming in to play a game like I was talking to him this morning, and he was nervous. You could see him with a little bit of nerves in his, you know, stepping on and playing in front of a big crowd. I guess the guy's played in front of the 80, 90,000 people at a time. But to come out and do what he's done, he's looking really steady.
There's part of me that wonders if he would have rather played in the NHL than the Premier League. You know, he loves hockey so much. He was such, you read out some of his accolades there. Just a few seconds remaining. And after 20, it'll be 3-1 Giants All-Stars. But you read out some of his accolades of his Premier League career, yet he's nervous to play here in a charity game.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, when I was bringing him from the airport this morning, he was telling me that hockey is his first love. He grew up playing hockey, and due to the expense of it, he just, you know, they just couldn't afford it. And he decided to go to football. Wasn't a bad idea, in fairness, you know, to come out and have the successful career that he had. But as soon as he got the chance to come back on again, 25 years, he hadn't skated in 25 years, and he steps out and does this. Last night he's at Chelsea versus Real Madrid. Tonight he's starring for the Sunderland Belfast Giants All-Star team.
My favorite moment with him was I was in Guildford to do a game, Guildford Sheffield. He said, oh, I'd love to come on the broadcast when we were on free sports. And the Zamboni broke down in behind us. We were standing in about 3 or 4 inches of snow and Zamboni water, the runoff. And this guy behind was hitting the Zamboni with a wrench. And I was talking to Petr Cech, who was one of the best Premier League goalies of all time. And such is the world of sport. It's a bit of magic.
Unreal. Unreal indeed. Well, we're going to take a short break.
3-1 after 20. Don't go anywhere. Don't forget, go to BelfastGiants.com/donate. The Hockey Can't Stop Tour. Donate now.
Straight's Matt McLeod to put it home.
I'm Ukrainian hockey player.
I really like playing hockey.
I'm sad because I don't know when I will get on the ice. There is a war in my country.
I don't know when I will see my friends.
And my team.
I miss them.
My mother is scared of sirens.
And I'm not afraid.
I'm very brave
because all hockey players are brave.
When I went out
on the ice,
I felt very strong.
I want to continue to be strong.
I want to play hockey.
I dream to play in the national team of Ukraine.
I dream to play in the NHL. I dream to play hockey.
The opponent is Kherson, a team in the top league. They've won trophies before, but more importantly, they've recently lost their rink. So it's much more than a hockey game in that we're raising profile for the cause over there, but also raising funds to hopefully support and building of new rinks.
I think special is the word. We are a charity, and the idea that we can help another charity in its time of need is special. The fact that Ukraine has suffered the loss and devastation that it has, and that we in some small way can hopefully contribute to the survival of hockey in that country is the right thing to do. And I would call on all Giants supporters, Giants friends, to come that night, fill this place, and give these Ukrainian people the welcome that they deserve.
It means a lot to the Trust to be involved, and to be entirely fair to my colleagues in the Trust who work day and daily, they came up with this as a concept. The Belfast Giants are a successful ice hockey team. I never really thought there'd be a point of time in my career where I used the phrase, ice hockey is an enabler, but it has been an enabler for so many of the programs that we have run here at the Trust. And on this occasion, as I say, the idea was to take it out a little bit wider and help somebody beyond our own shores.
Belfast Harbour, we're really thrilled to be involved in this event. It's very exciting both for us within the harbour and within the wider harbour estate community, but also for everyone within Northern Ireland to bring such an exciting event to the shores. I think, you know, as community outreach partner for the Giants, this is really fits really well within our strategy of community engagement right across the region as we develop a port for everyone across the region and a gateway for opportunity for everyone within the region.
We've got some current players on this year's roster, and we've got asked out to a lot of players that have played here before, so it's going to be hopefully a celebration game with the success we've had this season, but also much more than just a hockey game.
Experience here is so small. I start playing here only this September. First of all, because our Ukrainian friends are playing in this team, and lots of others are playing there. And the younger friends got, I can meet them in such a difficult time, and they were able to come here.
Mike, did you want to give me a
and it's Vlad's story on the big screen. Of course, if you would like to help support, you'd be doing that by getting yourself down here to the SSE Arena tonight. You can also do that online, BelfastGiants.com. Feel free to share that link around. That is the link to the Ukrainian hockey dream. Thank you. tonight's charity, Ukrainian Hockey Dream. Of course, you're all supporting, and thank you so much for your support. It is the Registered Charity Foundation of the Ice Hockey Federation of Ukraine. The charity's goals include providing safety and support for players and staff, youth and professional training, arena restoration and development throughout Ukraine. Their fundraising goal, $15.6 million, and thank you for your help in raising those proceeds for tonight's games, ticket sales, and of course the GoFundMe, the online link, donation buckets, and the shirt off the back. All are going to be donated to that hugely important cause, raising money to support up to 7,500 young players, professionals, coaches, and staff members across more than 100 clubs and 15 schools throughout the range. Thank you so much, Neil Army, for your support, purchasing the ticket for tonight's game. You're helping to make that difference. If you'd like to make an additional contribution to the Ukrainian Hockey Dream, please visit BelfastGiants.com/today.
Welcome back to SSE Arena in beautiful Belfast, Northern Ireland, and it is the special night. I mean, the Giants have won all three trophies this year, but you get the sense that some of these players were just as excited about the Hockey Can't Stop Tour in aid of the Ukraine Hockey Dreams. But they didn't take it easy on Dnipro Kherson in the first period. The Giants with a 3-1 lead after 20.
Yeah, again, some good play from both teams, and you always get that when you get a challenge game and you sort of just, you know, a little bit of dipsy doodling between the legs and what have you. It's always great for the fans as well. And both goaltenders have come up with some good saves. The All-Star Belfast Giants lineup leading 3-2. And they've made a switch. And look at this here. Adam Keefe's dropped back in the back end now.
Giants head coach Adam Keefe and his assistant coach George Iwata, D partners to start period number two. Grant Cooper, Max Stewart, and Matt McLeod, the goal scorers for the Giants in period number one. 16-year-old Ilya Shcherbak on the goal, on the board with his goal, the youngest player in the game by far. Well, a little bit of a miscue there as the puck comes out of the corner. The goalie, Maxim Salyutin, decides to hold on.
Yeah, the player coach, Vasilev, tried to make a little wrist across the ice and didn't get all off it. And the goaltender paying attention, which is always smart as well. Otherwise, it could have been another notch in the post there for the Belfast Giants.
Face-off win by Kieran Long. Quick shot by Daryl Lloyd off the shoulder of Salyutin, who has been very good in this one. It could be a lot more than 3-1.
Yeah, for sure. Absolutely. He's done really, really well. You talk about, obviously, if it's a competitive game, you're getting more support, but it's you're coming up with big saves at the moment. Daryl Lloyd again, waiting for the face-off win.
Lloyd to Keefe, and a bygone era, Giants fans remember that particular pass. It's probably more physical that they're remembered for, but both players had good seasons back in their heyday with the Giants. Here's a chance to the back post, unable to get a piece of that, was Bondarenko. Back to the point, Vasilyev. Vasilyev's shot goes by Awada and Portnoy. Portnoy looking for Tyshchenko, but it is Adam Keefe dropping it for Lloyd. Lloyd up the left wing. Doesn't get it to Kieran Long. It's picked off by Seholorodtsev. Poked down the wing by Vasilyev. Spoke with Adam Keefe when I arrived this morning. Again, congratulated him on the playoff win and talked if he had any concerns about putting the blades back on. He said, yeah, I'm just kind of worried Daryl Lloyd is going to hit somebody in a challenge game. But such is Daryl Lloyd. He was like a heat-seeking missile, wasn't he?
And 1 minute, 20 seconds shift for Adam Keefe. And he's going to need a hand to get off the ice there. I don't think he meant to stay on that long. He's on the wrong side for the long change.
Here's Tsitsira. Pikinich for Awada. Awada using his size to A-frame on the blue line, allow Pikinich to come in. But good recovery by Kherson. Zvornik sprinting forward. He's got good wheels. Zvornik swooped out wide, kept to the outside. Dvornik battling against Tim Cook. Goodwin, the captain of the Belfast Giants this past season. Pikinich, saucer pass across for Conway, named the Elite League's top forward and the Elite League's outstanding player this season. He had 40 goals in league action. Here's Pikinich. Pikinich got his pocket picked by Pankov and a three-on-one developing back the other way. Dvornik was open. Swindlehurst, excellent defensive work from Swindlehurst. Here's Dvornik. Hard angle shot turned aside by Petr Cech. And now it'll be Saviano. Pikinich off the skate of Saviano. Poke checked away by Lishnikov. Conway tried a fancy little pass there, and Olenek. Olenek, long range shot. And Petr Cech, he looks calm and cool in the net, and certainly with his size, he takes up so much of the 6x4 net.
Yeah, the Giants have been used to that this year with the bulk and the size of Tyler Beskarwani. And, you know, obviously, Petr Cech coming in here and doing the same job as Besko's done all year is looking good.
Portnoy slots it ahead for Vasilyev. Vasilyev out wide. Long range shot off the stick of Arsen Olenek, a 19-year-old. There's plenty of teenage presence on this Kherson team, including the goal scorer, Ilya Shcherbak, just 16 years of age. Swindlehurst, a former Giant, former Team GB defenseman now, Manchester policeman. Here's Saviano. Saviano tries back post. Picked off by Bondarenko. Grant Cooper, who opened up the scoring back in period one, pressing it on him, but Garside will have to retreat out there with Kel Beattie, Max Stewart. Also, Beattie and Stewart representing GB at under 20 level this season internationally. Here's Cooper. Mark Cooper, 21 goals in league action for the Giants this season. Kicks it along, kept to the outside by Tyshchenko. Off the skate of Grant Cooper, and a little bit of a different feel to start this period as both teams a little bit more defensively responsible.
Yeah, they're taking more, and they're not taking as many chances so far in this opening second period, the 4 minutes that have gone so far. But again, as a professional athlete, no matter what your sport, what your code is, you don't want to lose.
Doesn't matter if it's a fun game, a charity game, or otherwise, you do not want to be on the losing end. Here's Garside. McLeod, Max Stewart, tried to go five holes, so Uten showed it and took it away right away. Khorbunov, Ihor Khorbunov, wearing 19 now. I thought he was going to wear 5. Such as it's fun for us. We've had to guess a few things. Here's Pankov. Pankov walks in. Tried to put it off the back of the pad of Petrček. And Bondarenko now. Sidesteps a hit from Bast. Curling away is Dvornik. Dvornik out front. Nobody home. And Pankov. Pankov dishes. Leshnikov. Dvornik now. Poke checked away. And he'll have to give chase as Bast will retreat back. He realized he was coming forward. There was no one in behind as Sahalaradsev was in behind everyone in teal. Here is Sahalaradsev. Nice little move. Tried to go to the backhand. Poke check by Bass, and Sahalaradsev will throw it into the corner to Sitsura. Lishnikov plays it back in. Jeff Baum. Baum got his pocket picked there by Lishnikov. Good pressure below the hash marks from Dnipro Kherson, but back the other way comes McLeod, who had a goal in period one. Here's Eriksson, who had 2 assists. He was maybe the most impressive stick handler in that first period. Really showed some of his silky smoothness in period one.
Yeah, Eriksson, you know, he came in here in the start of January, done really well, scored a couple of really important goals, and that 6-1 victory against the Guildford Flames, which eventually won the league for the Giants. He came up with 2 huge goals. You were commentating on that for Viaplay, and, you know, obviously, you know, to score those 2 goals in a big game like that, he certainly would have been feeling pretty good.
McLeod with a little chip shot off the shoulder of Salyutin, who at 5'9" is quite small in the net. You can see he pops up there with the shoulder. Good reactions. Pass intended for Anatoly Ravuka, who's just 17 years old. It was too far for him. And look at Petrček. He actually handles the puck very well on the backhand for a goalkeeper.
Do you know what? Obviously, it's his experience of playing professional sport for so many years. He's extremely fit and still very agile for what he, you know, for the age he is now. And it's just incredible to have a player of his caliber. Weller's football. Oh, there's Adam Keefe. He got one big block shot there from the coach. And everybody in the bench is up in the ears.
Portnoy with the one-time slapper. And Adam Keefe. Much like I said in the first period, my first game up here, the Keefe legend. He blocked a shot with his neck and popped right back up. Right there, he blocks a shot. And it seems to wake him up when he takes physical punishment. Here's Kieran Long. Long walking in, sends it to the back post. Another pass across, looking for Jonathan Boxall. And Salyutin had the goalkeeper's paddle across.
We talk about the ex-players that are here. Obviously, Adam Keefe, you know, and the all-time leading penalty minutes for Adam Keefe with 1,130. And he played 369 games for Belfast. And when you're looking at other players, the experience that is in that lineup of the All-Stars tonight, you know, we can't skip past George Iwata. George Iwata, 376 games, sits third in the points all time as a Belfast Giant. And, you know, it's great to see him back out there again.
Here's Bondarenko, chips it away from Conway. Kept in by Cook. No, it just skipped over his blade as Bondarenko chasing him down. Swindlehurst will get there. Rips up the left side. Nobody home in a teal jersey. Dvornik. Dvornik with a nice little move. Dvornik out front and padded away by Petrček. As now Goodwin will rumble down the right side. One hand on the stick. He got poke checked. Stepping up is Cook. Cook to Pikanić. To Conway. This was a line last year before Pikanić went off to Continental Europe. Pikanić. Held up by Pankov. Pankov goes down. Conway. Conway, what a move by Conway, showing you the silky smooth mitts. Goodwin goes up and over the crossbar. As they've connected all season long like that, en route to 3 trophies in the Viaplay Elite League, the Challenge Cup, and of course the playoffs. Here's Goodwin. Off the skate of Pankov. Pankov on for Bondarenko. Bondarenko, it's a 3-0. Well, what a stick there. They had so many options, and it was turned aside by the youngster Kel Beatty. Here's Conway. Conway chips it back. Pikanić was ready for the one-timer, but Lishnikov. Lishnikov ahead, in, and what a blocker save. And Sitsura was in all alone, and Sitsura is robbed by Petrček.
Another huge save from Petrček in the All-Stars net. Did a giveaway. Great pass through the middle and right down Royal Avenue, and a big blocker save by the goaltender.
Comes out and challenges, and you forget how big he is, because when you watched him back in the Premier League, the massive football net, he looks so gigantic in a 6x4 hockey, and he comes out to the top of the blue paint, and he's almost willing the shooter on that occasion, Sri Sisura, for a perfect shot, which didn't come. Good blocker save. Here's Saviano. On for Cooper, Mark Cooper. Mark Cooper with the chance. Toe saved by Sal Uten. And Maxim Sal Uten, the 21-year-old in the nets for Kherson, is keeping them close. They're down by a pair. Here's Lisnikov. Right into the Giants logo on the chest of Petr Cech.
Mark Cooper at the other end, trying to make a little move in front. Lovely dish through the middle by Steve Saviano. And coming up big, again, the goaltender right on his line, just getting that left foot against the post. Huge save. I know Randy and Lillian Cooper will be watching on home in Toronto this afternoon. Big disappointment for their team last night, their main team last night in the Toronto Maple Leafs.
But I did not. I you know what? Tampa Bay are good, of course. That's Captain Obvious stuff. But I did not see the Leafs losing 6-2 last night. So condolences to any Leafs fans out there. As a Bruins guy, I was pretty happy with their opening night performance. Here's Baum. No doubt if Mr. Baum, the senior Bomber, is watching tonight. He's a Dallas Stars guy. We had a great chat with him in Nottingham. I wanted to get to Bunkers Hill for a beer with him, but he did it before the game, and I couldn't have a beer before the broadcast. Here's a chance down low, tucking it home is Saviano. Steve Saviano makes it 4-1.
Great goal by Saviano. Again, that line of the two Coopers and Saviano combining, coming up with a big goal to make it 4-1 here at the SSC Arena. And the first goal in the Scotland are going to bring a goaltender change as Petr Cech makes way for Andre Dixon. And what a performance from the ex-Chelsea goaltender, goalkeeper, I was going to say. He's been outstanding tonight. But great to see Andre Dixon getting some ice time, taking the plaudits from the fans around the SSC Arena. Dicko's been here for a long time, and another goaltender change at the other end as well.
Andrew Dixon, in his 12th year in teal, five times a league champion, will replace Petr Cech, and Nazari Sushak will now tend the net for Dnipro Kherson after Saviano's goal from Mark Cooper. Cooper with his second assist of the game, and Jeff Baum with a helper on Saviano's goal. 4-1 in favor of the Giants. We should talk about Andrew Dixon because, you know what, he's backed up. He's had to start, but he's also, he knows he's the third goalie here. He's part of the practice, the important practice routine of the Giants, and he's happy to be a part of the squad, and he has, over the years, been such a vital member of this Giants operation.
He's the first guy on the ice every practice, the last guy off. He stays out for extra shooting practice for the guys when they want to. He's an integral part of this organization for all that time. And it's, again, it's fantastic to see him getting a bit of ice time here this season. It's been a tough year for him when you have the goaltenders of the quality of Beskarwani, Jackson Whistle, and obviously Peyton Jones has started the season here. Dicko didn't get many options and to play, but again, you know, I've always said it, he doesn't realize how important to this organization that he actually is.
100%. You need those guys that at practice. You need those guys who are good teammates. Here's Max Stewart. Henrik Eriksson goes out wide. Tried to throw it back post. We should also mention the likes of equipment manager Jason Taff-Ellery. He's the heartbeat of this squad. Takes care of all the things that happen behind the scenes to allow the players to do their job. He's also the Team GB equipment manager. Keefe. Keefe with a long range shot. Well, that was a nice little snapshot from Adam Keefe. Awada kicks it along. Keith with the good hands. Back to McLeod. McLeod trying to dangle, and Poprzej is right in his face, but we know how fast McLeod is. He comes back and wins that puck. Here's Adam Keith rumbling down the right side. Goes to the backhand, drops it for McLeod. McLeod trying to get it back to Henrik Eriksson, but it will drift all the way back as it will be Awada to Eriksson. Eriksson glove save by Nazari Sushak.
Sushak coming up with a huge save. He's only in net, and it's good for him to get a couple of early saves. Adam Keith coming up with a shot on target, and he'll be busting to try and get a goal here tonight. He does a little bit of showing off in practice in the morning before the boys come on the ice, so he'll be busting to try and get on that score sheet.
Well, right now, he's got a blocked shot and a shot, so an SOG and a BS. It's a successful tour of duty thus far for Adam Keith. Swindlehurst got his wires crossed there. Ravuka will take advantage. Ravuka with a nice move. Ravuka with a chance, and Andrew Dixon came out to play it. Might have got the cheater of that left hand up in time. Here's Olenek. Olenek off the shin pad of Tim Cook, and that will send Kihor Khurbanov all the way back and down. He's being watched by Boxall. Boxall took a good line there on the forecheck. Penkov out wide to Ravuka. Ravuka, Siura. Siura with a chance, and it's tucked home by Penkov. Bogdan Penkov makes it 4-2.
Penkov gets the second goal again for Dnipro. Shot coming in from the top of the circles. Not too sure if Jackson, or sorry, my apologies, Andrew Dixon was screened in front. And he just misplaced the glove on that one, but it popped right out front. And we'll keep on saying, get Lynette, you get rewarded. And they've got it back to two within two.
Tira's shot was off the fingertips, it looked like, of the glove of Andrew Dixon coming in cold. But it will be tucked home by Bogdan Penkov, who had five goals this past season for Dnipro Kherson. Long to Boxall. Boxall, long range wrist shot. And Shushak, who has replaced Solyutin in the goal, will make the save.
Jonathan Boxall, again, getting a quick shot away there in his Giants career. 21 goals in just over 200 games. Played an important part. Do you remember the block? You would have been commentating the game back for Premier Sports at the time. And the block against the Guildford Flames with about a couple minutes to go to get it in the overtime in Cardiff, the Challenge Cup final 2019. And he still says to me that that's still, even to this day, he can sort of feel a bit of, caught it in the backside at that point, but he has a little bit of tenderness around that area every once in a while.
Those sort of things, they hurt, but they're lessened with winning, and a big win that evening for the Giants. And we forget, Jonathan Boxall also played for Team GB, so he had an international stint as well. Here's JJ Pickenich. Pickenich walks in. Pickenich tries to go high, does so. Pickenich on his return to SSE Arena has a goal. It's 5-2.
JJ, it was inevitable that he was going to get on the score sheet here tonight in some capacity. Very, very skillful player. He had 100 points for the Belfast Giants last year in only 68 games. And that trio, as we talked about it earlier, Gubin, Conway and Pickenich combining here again tonight. And the Giants now lead 5-2.
And Nazeri Sushak looked like a 20-year-old netminder, played it well. It just comes off his glove and up and over into that top corner. Pickenich has those silky smooth hands though. Former Toronto Maple Leafs draft pick back in 2014, JJ Pickenich. Here's Olenek. Being watched by Conway. Lishnikov. Lishnikov, four goals, 12 assists this past season for Kherson. Plays it around the rim for Boyko. Boyko gets his pocket picked by Goodwin. Goodwin to Conway, tried to bunt that out of the air, but Nazeri Sushak will hold on.
Talk about JJ Pickenich. Back when he was playing with the London Knights, he played with a couple of guys who, you know, they've become pretty well known. Dvorak, Mitch Marner,
Matthew Tkachuk. Not too bad.
Won the Memorial Cup that year. You know, and JJ was an integral part of that squad. And you know, he still, you know, he contacts Mitchie every once in a while. Especially, I mean, Tkachuk's had a standout year this year as well.
Here's Sherbak, the 16-year-old, closed out by Kel Beattie. Kel Beattie, the product, Northern Ireland local product is Kel Beattie. Good defensive line by Kel Beattie against Bogdan Penkov, who has a goal in this period for Dnipro Kherson, but it's 5-2 Giants All-Stars on the answer back from JJ Pickenich. Stretch play for Grant Cooper. Grant Cooper just too far. He kept on side, though. Here's Saviano. Saviano plays it back. Unfortunately, Gabe Bast will have to back up. Tape to tape with Baum. Off the skate of Cooper. Cooper with a pair of assists in the game. Getting back first, though, is Khurbanov. Ihor Khurbanov. Ravuka now. Ravuka up the left wing. There's some room down that left wing, but not able to get a hold of it. It was Bondarenko. And Jeff Baum just too fleet of foot. He will get back for the Giants. Here's Grant Cooper. Mark Cooper, too far for Bast. Picked off, Khurbanov. Poprzyj off the shoulder of Dixon and out the other side, Cooper. Bast launching it forward for Max Stewart. Stewart has a goal in this one, but he touches it offside with 5:04 remaining. Giants 5, Dnipro Kherson 2.
I think both teams are sort of finding their feet there. The speed is, of the game has picked up a little bit as well. You talk about, you know, how fast the game's gone. There's only 5 minutes left in the second period. The Giants leading 5-2. But, again, an entertaining game for what it is. And it's great. I'm just looking around the arena seeing so many of the Ukraine flags being supported. We know that there's a number of Ukraine families who, unfortunately, lost their homes when the situation started back in the Ukraine. And they're now calling Northern Ireland home. They've called, came from all over Northern Ireland this evening. And it's great to see so many people celebrating for hopefully, as I say, we can raise a lot of money tonight.
You can reach out belfastgiants.com/donate. Hockey can't stop. Donate now if you can. Erickson to McLeod. Vasiliev with a good defensive play on McLeod. McLeod trying to go back door. Too far for Bass. But Erickson, Henrik Erickson's been a lot of fun to watch this evening. Gives it away on that occasion, though, as I jinx him. Bondarenko. Bondarenko trying to go right up Main Street. Poked away by Baum and Stewart. We'll send it back to Bass. It's a good point by you. I mean, you and I were lucky. We're around hockey all the time. Our biggest worry, your biggest worry is, will the Giants win? My biggest worry is if I'll miss a flight to get to a game. But there's people with so many more concerns than us. So if you can give a few pounds, a few euros, or a few dollars this evening, all proceeds tonight will go to UK Hockey Dream. Here's Setsalarovtsov, and what a play there by Adam Keefe on Setsalarovtsov. Stick-on-stick play. There's fight in the coach yet. Here's Keefe. Keefe goes out wide of Boyko. Kicked along by Dvornik. Sahalaradsev trying to get the puck away from Kieran Long. Played back to Tsira. Sahalaradsev. Leshnikov came off the boot of his skater. He went and had a shot. Here's Keefe. Keefe sends it cross ice to McLeod. McLeod poke checked by Dvornik. Good defensive play by Mikola Dvornik. Down the right wing, cuts back, lovely set of hands, and Dvornik walks in, and what a stop by Dixon as the rebound was there for Nikita Lishnikov, but a right pad save by Dixon.
Great play by Dicko, getting that right pad right against that post. An important moment in the game, but great hands coming off the wall again from Ukraine, and some of these kids are really skillful, and take into consideration they have not a lot of ice time this year. And they're certainly not letting themselves down. They're doing really well.
Lishnikov, 4 plus 12 this season. Dvornik, 8 plus 22. Going close there, but that's a good right pad save from Andrew Dixon. Sierra couldn't keep the puck along the wall. Boxel will come in. He'll have to wait for Kieran Long to come back onside. And Jonathan Boxel used to wear 89, if I'm not incorrect.
Did.
And yeah. Now Long is wearing 89. Out there with Boxel wearing 55. Cullen usually wears 55, so it's just one of those confusing moments for me, but no confusion there as Anatoly Revuka, the 17-year-old, wheels, fires, 5-3 hockey game.
Yeah, I think he actually poked the stick away from Andrew Dixon. The puck was right there. Dicko had it covered up, and I think he was actually just waiting for a whistle, but then he tried to throw it away, misplayed it out front, and a little bit of a swing. Revuka slots it home. And they're now back within two again.
You talk about the young skill on show. We've got a goal from a 16-year-old Sherbak and a 17-year-old Revuka. The future bright for those two players. Face-off win by Conway. Here's Tim Cook. Swindlehurst. Pickenich poke checked by Vasiliev. Here's Conway. Conway with that little stutter step. He was poke checked at the last second by Portnoy. Goodwin kicks it along. 2.5 minutes remaining in the middle frame. 5-3 hockey game. Belfast Giants All-Stars against Dnipro Kherson. Hope you're enjoying action this evening. Aaron Murphy alongside Simon Kitchen on an important night to raise funds for the Ukraine hockey dream. And an entertaining evening so far. Tyschenko dropped it back, but Pickenich is there. Pickenich goes down. The referee, Andy Dalton, the linesman, Vitas Lukasiewicz, and the other linesman, James Nelson. The whistles are well and truly in the back pocket. We haven't seen any power plays. We've seen no reason for any power plays. But we should tip the cap to Daltz and the crew. Cook to Pickenich. I believe Andy Dalton, Vitas Lukasiewicz, and James Nelson also donating their time this evening for this game to be able to take place as everyone tries to pinch in the best way they can. Here's Dvornik. Sends it cross ice. Boyko. Boyko tried to force that shot through. Kel Beattie with a stick-on-stick play. Bondarenko stripped by the youngster Beattie. 1:20 remaining in the second period. Giants with a two-goal cushion. Sahalorotsev across the red line. Enters right up the middle. Sahalorotsev wearing that number 87 jersey a la Sidney Crosby. Sticking out the left hand, trying to protect the puck. Plays it back to Tsitsura. Tsitsura poke check by Conway, and now Kel Beattie works it on. A little play forward, and here comes Goodwin. Goodwin with the showtime move back between the legs and flipped it up and over the blocker of Sushek, but could not hit the target. But the captain showing some razzle-dazzle there. Here comes Pankov. Pankov, nice little move around Beattie, but good layers there defensively from Garside. Garside so defensively responsible. Here comes Mark Cooper. Mark Cooper throws on the brakes, waits for reinforcements. Slides it along. Saviano looking for his second. Saviano jabbing at it. It goes through the goal mouth as Sushak was desperate to find that puck. Saviano with a couple of whacks at it. Here's Grant Cooper. Back to Saviano. Walks out front. Left pad saved by Nazeri Sushak. Sahalorotsev trying to get in behind Kel Beattie. Beattie had it in his skates. Sahalorotsev, who's on about a 2.5 minute shift here. Sahalorotsev still has some energy. Beattie comes back at him, and as the buzzer sound, well, we've got ourselves a hockey game, Simon Kitchen, a 5-3 scoreline through 40 minutes of play.
Yeah, again, thoroughly entertaining charity game here this evening. Any other the Ukraine hockey dreams, fantastic to see so many people out there. And do you know what, just rolling back here, Steve Saviano, and love watching young Sal on the ice, and it's great to see that he's playing the game as always with a smile on his face. But old Swindlehurst and Tim Cook on the back end, you know, two big bodies, they look as if they could play. Still be playing as well. So fantastic to see such a good crowd in here tonight, and everybody enjoying themselves.
BelfastGiants.com/donate. If you can give a few euro, a few dollars, a few pounds, hockey can't stop. Donate now. Aaron Murphy, Simon Kitchen will step aside. It's a 5-3 scoreline in favor of the Giants All-Stars over Dnipro Kherson. Third period action ahead from SSE Arena. Don't go anywhere.
switch over to Michael. And Michael's going to bring it home along the green cart. Chris back there, neck and neck. Dave is next to take on the blue carts.
Мене звати Владислав Колопишин. Я українець, я граю за юніорську команду Giants.
So I started playing hockey maybe in 2015 when I first time going with my grandfather to like city center, and in city center have ice bowl, and grandfather taught me to skating, and I decided I want to play hockey. I play for a junior Belfast Giants. My experience here is so small, so because I start playing here only with September.
Finnish Nerlandas, the Northern Ireland met us with rain and with the cold. But as it always happens, everything that starts badly can usually end up in a good way.
Тут прекрасні, добрі люди.
The people here are nice and kind, and this country is very good and nice with its landscape and with the quality of life.
Так,
yes, I'm looking forward to this game. First of all, because our Ukrainian friends are playing in this team, and Vlad's coach as well is playing there. Thanks God, I can meet them in such a difficult time and they're able to come here.
Oh, my journey was very long, and now we are 8 months in there. I like Northern Ireland. I like weather because some people don't like weather in Northern Ireland. But I like, and I like what every time green.
I think I like the schools or people. People are here very kind.
Where I live in Ukraine, my town was Donetsk, east of part of Ukraine. We have big hockey club, this Donbass. We have been in Titanic Museum, Ulster Museum, but we want maybe end April we'll go to museum.
My name is Dina. I work at like charity organization called For the Friends of Ukraine. We are in Derry and we try to help people who want to move from Ukraine, who are still in Ukraine and who want to move here because you know that it's too dangerous to stay in Ukraine, and here is a great opportunity for people because we have a lot of support from government and because of people, of course. I help people to apply to visas and other things. But also we support people who are already here. So it could be anything. Some girls can ask me when they can have good nails or something like this, you know. So it's not about just official communication. I do like Northern Ireland. I do like Derry. Everyone whom I have met was really supporting, really kind, really friendly. I didn't expect to have so much support here. I'm not really keen on hockey, but I do want to support our guys because, you know, we try to support people, we try to support Ukraine any way as we can, and I'm excited before the game, so we want to bring all our like flag, posters, people, and do our best.
Hey, Cameron 96, rounding us off there on our dance count tonight. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Some great moves on the dance count tonight. Really back underway. Very shortly, tonight's big game. But of course, this game couldn't happen without lots of people behind the event. So a giant thank you to our event sponsors, Belfast Farmers, Stepline Car Travel, and many more all up there on the big screen and around the ring boards as well. So a giant thank you to them, and of course, the Odyssey Trust, for putting the work in to put the event together and make this happen. And a huge thank you to you, the team of the people of Belfast, from wherever, it doesn't matter. Thank you so much for coming along tonight to support this event here at the SSE Arena Belfast.
Third period action ahead at SSE Arena after 40 minutes of play. A 5-3 scoreline in favor of the Belfast Giants All-Stars over Dnipro Kherson from the Ukraine. Goal scorers in this one, Grant Cooper, Max Stewart, Matt McLeod, Steve Saviano, and JJ Pikinich. And for the visitors, 16-year-old Ilya Sherbak and 17-year-old Bogdan Pankov. Anatoly Ravuka, is the 17-year-old Bogdan Pankov starting the scoring in that second period for Kherson, who were 4 goals adrift at one point, but here they are, a couple of goals down in what has become a really magical evening. We're trying to raise some money for the Ukraine hockey dream. BelfastGiants.com/donate. Hope you can spare a few shillings.
Absolutely. The more the merrier, guys. As I say, anybody listening, if you can spare, if you get a little bit of spare change, I know times are going to be difficult and over the last couple of years, but this is a very, very worthwhile charity, and hopefully you can help out in any way you can.
The puck is down on period 3. Vasiliev, the captain, the player coach, sends it cross ice. Kieran Long stretches the zone. Daryl Lloyd. Vasiliev. Lloyd, Keefe, and Boxall. A real crash and bash line out here, although this is a no-hitter this evening. It's all for fun, of course. Zaharetsev trying to go up and over the left hand of Andrew Dixon. If you're just tuning in, of course, Chelsea legend Petr Cech started in the goal for the Giants All-Stars, and Andrew Dixon is on in relief. 12th year with the Giants for Dixon. Here's Long. Long with a nice inside-out move off the mask of Sushek, who's also on in release. So Yutin had started the game in the net for Kherson.
Sushak's done really well since he came in. The first two big saves he had, actually two shots that he had initially. Two big saves, one glove save, and certainly started out the right way, for sure.
Puck too far for Sahalaradsev, and it will be Swindlehurst up the left side for Goodwin. Here's Conway. Drops it for Goodwin. Goodwin with 55 assists in league play this year for the Giants. That's unbelievable. In 54 games, Sitsura. Sitsura back into the middle of the ice looking for Dvornik. Cross ice and just launching it up and over the crossbar. It was Poprzej. Poprzej, a right-handed shot on the left side. He had plenty of room, but he put it over the crossbar. Here comes Goodwin. Goodwin for the speedster Pikanich. Pikanich with a goal in period number two. It was 3-1 Giants after 20, 5-3 through 40. Garside. One pass too many, perhaps, as he tried to go back into the slot for Conway. Garside deftly stick handling back as Poprzej was trying to lift a stick. Dvornik trying to win it back. Good layers from the Giants. Garside tried to put it quickly through the middle. It's intercepted by Pankov. Pankov turned back. Lesnikov. Caught on a line change here, Pikanich in front. Conway is robbed by Sushak. Lovely save by the 20-year-old netminder for Kherson. Long range shot for Sherbak. Looked like it was going to go wide, but Andrew Dixon will hold on.
Yeah, just holding on to that one, and instead of letting it go around the wall, and a big save at the other end by Sushak, coming up big and getting an opportunity there.
Older than dirt. Is that me on the big screen? You've done that.
Happy birthday, Murph.
No better way to spend it.
But could not put it on here on the big screens in the SSE arena for you. 40-something, I'm not allowed to say that.
40, yeah. No better way to spend it. When the call came from yourself and Steve Thornton, the answer was yes. It's always yes when there's a good cause. Here's Saviano. Lesnikov, Bass with the shot, blockered away by Sushak. Lovely stop by Nazari Sushak. Here's Cooper, Mark Cooper, back into the middle of the ice. Cooper is so strong at 6'2", over 200 pounds. Here's Grant Cooper, who opened up the scoring way back in period number one. Really appreciate it, Simon. You look at it, you and I are lucky. We do the Friendship Four together. We've had many great moments in hockey, both as competitors. Oh, we'll come back to that point. Sahalaradsev walking in. Sahalaradsev. Oh, what a finish! Artem Sahalaradsev makes it 5-4.
Great play. Just cutting into his, on his forehand, left-handed, lifting over the pads of Andrew Dixon. Top goal scorer again. Really impressive move by Sahalaradsev. Coming up big, and they get it back within one. It's now 5-4.
This is a lovely finish, too, Sis. He goes forehand, back to the forehand, to the roof of the net. He had Andrew Dixon moving around a little bit. And up and over a sprawled out Dicko. Before that goal, though, I mean, you and I are lucky. Look around here, the Friendship for the NCAA hockey that's been here. We've had some fun moments at tournaments and Great Britain and all that. That's off the crossbar on the shot from Eriksson. The important thing to remember this evening, whether it's your birthday or whether it's your anniversary or whether you're a returning Giant, it's about the charity event this evening. And again, if you can donate anything, Veselorosev stopped by Dixon. Sahalaradsev nearly had his pocket picked there by Eriksson. Staying with it, McLeod, Awada and Keefe. Coaches now for the Giants, taking another shift here in period three. 4 minutes gone. Here's Eriksson. Eriksson's putting on a show this evening. Showtime! Rebound for Max Stewart. And Stewart looking for his second of the game. Two assists in the game for Eriksson. Awada But again, back to that point, BelfastGiants.com/donate. Anything you can give can help with the Ukraine hockey dream. McLeod. McLeod, let me turn the puck over. Tyschenko. Danilo Tyschenko. Bondarenko. Tyschenko, a lefty down the right side. Poked away by Swindlehurst. Bondarenko. Pankov. Poprijai's shot launches wide. Boxel picks it up on the right wing. Taps it back to Tim Cook. McLeod. Three on two developing. Swindlehurst instead goes to the bench. McLeod, though, doesn't need the help. He'll throw it into the middle of the ice. And Boxel's shot came off the stick of Poprijai up and over the goal. There's a chance for Daryl Lloyd. The crowd would love it if Daryl Lloyd could stick one home, as well as Adam Keefe. Time not on the side of both those players. They haven't had a lot of ice time here from about the halfway part of the second period onwards. Tsitsura. Poprijai, as we have the Causeway Clap, an early edition of the Causeway Clap here. Lloyd for Long. Long goes to the backhand, tried to go through the wickets of Sushak, who got the stick down. Here's Pickenich. Pickenich gives it away to Sri Tsitsura. Tsitsura is it back in the middle of the ice, nearly gave it away to Lloyd, and now rumbling forward is Pickenich. Pickenich off the shoulder of Sushak, up and out of play.
RJJ Pickenich showing silky hands, coming in on a partial breakaway. Nice get close down from behind. Tried to go upstairs over the shoulder of Shishka, and a big save from the goaltender. Just at the weekend, I'm not too sure, but something just, I was looking through the stats. We got in Belfast Giants TV, Davey McGimsey does all the stats for the Giants organization, and he hasn't picked up on this yet, so I don't know, but I think he's watching at home. But Mark Garsay picked up an assist on Jeff Baum's goal on Sunday, and he now moves into sixth place overall in the all-time point scoring for the standalone Belfast Giants, overtaking Blair Riley. 233 points now, 57 goals and 176 assists.
Well, Garside started out his career as a forward, a very good forward, a good centerman, two-way player, and moved to defense, and it's probably extended his career to somewhat move him back to the points. Ravuk out front, Tsitsura denied by Andrew Dixon. Big stop by Dicko.
Didn't know where it was, and you're always looking for a lucky goaltender every once in a while as well. Good shot from the forward coming in, and Dicko just managing to hold on to that one and keeping it that one goal lead. But a play on the corner of the far blue line here, and a big chance to clear it, but Belfast couldn't get it away.
You mentioned earlier, and also another important point, the SSC Arena Odyssey Trust, all ticket sales this evening, 100% going to the cause tonight, which just shows, again, the class of the club and all the leadership around the Belfast Giants.
There's nothing surprised me about this organization now. We're very, very lucky that the Odyssey Trust own the club and own the SSC Arena and W5 and Life Learning Center as well. It's fantastic what they've done for the organization over the last number of years. And we're just going to continue to grow.
Baum was stopped. Mark Cooper is stopped. Grant Cooper. Nazeri Sushak has done a great job since coming in, but Maxim Silyutin was good as well. Bast inches his way into the corner. 12:45 remaining in the third period. Just the one goal cushion now for the Giants All-Stars. Grant Cooper's shot redirected by Mark Cooper and patted away by Sushak. Bondarenko loses the puck. Here's Mark Cooper. Mark Cooper, they pass it around, and Grant Cooper slots it home. Grant Cooper with his second 6-4 hockey game.
We said it earlier on. Tic-tac-toe. Grant Cooper, an easy shot on target, but what a great heads-up play from Gabe Bass. We talk about, you know, how good he's been this year in the Elite League. I honestly believe he's been the best defenseman in the league all season long. He's only missed one game all year, and he has been absolutely outstanding. And a great play by the Giants, number 42.
And Mark Cooper with his third assist. You're right about Gabe Bass. I think back to the Champions Hockey League playing against the likes of Skellefteå, Swedish Giant, and I thought, this Gabe Bass is a player. He started off well, continued on all the way to that playoff final. Here's McLeod. Grant Cooper with his second. Mark Cooper with three apples, an assist for Bass. Pass intercepted by Pankov. Pankov that was met by Jeff Baum. Poprzej. Poprzej inches his way into the corner. Out front, trying to jam it home was Lesnikov. And Dixon, a couple of big saves here in the third period from Andrew Dixon.
Yep, they go coming up big. Again, you'll be disappointed, but giving that third one up at the end of the first, the second period, my apologies. But he's done a great job here in the third. Just under 12 minutes to go, and it's all to play for. It's only 6-4, and Dnipro have done really well to come back on a couple of occasions, so maybe they can get another one.
Shots on goal through 40 minutes were 33-22 in favor of the Giants All-Stars. So some good goalkeeping on show between the pipes for Dnipro Kherson. Henrik Eriksson, a couple of points this evening. Back post, what a shot, McLeod! Into the roof of the net, and McLeod has his second.
And another assist for Henrik Eriksson. Great vision from Eriksson behind the net. Throwing it out front, and a wrister goes upstairs over the top of the shoulder of Šuška. And the Giants extend their lead.
Eriksson with three assists, McLeod. And it looks like, actually, Šuška got a piece of that, but such was the velocity of the shot off the stick of McLeod into the roof of the net. It was 5-4, and the Giants All-Stars put the skate down. Regaining a bit of a cushion now. Adam Keefe playing on the point with George Iwata. Giveaway. Sakhlarantsev out front. Chischenko, and Chischenko, look at Dixon, comes right out to the top of the blue paint to make that save.
Again, this Dnipro team are really impressing me. Their movement, their vision, just getting it out front, and just a little flick of the shoulder there, tries to go upstairs. An opportunity to get back within two from Chischenko. And Dixon again coming up big.
Dangerous pass, cross ice from George Iwata. You know that as the assistant coach of the Giants, he would be sitting down a defenseman who tried that cross-ice pass in his own zone. It doesn't hurt them, though. Here's Daryl Lloyd to Boxel. Back for Iwata. Iwata with a chance, and Iwata is denied by Šušek. And his big George Iwata pinched in from the point. Now Adam Keefe is back. Sakhlarantsev challenging Keefe. Bondarenko flipping it back to Portnoy. Portnoy outworked by Kieran Long, 2-on-1 developing. Long and Conway. Long with a shot. Turned aside by the right pad of Nazeri Šušek. Sakhlarantsev, he's been impressive. He's got a goal here in the third period. Swings out wide of Pekinich, dropped it for Iwata. Iwata's at the end of a long shift. Wants to get to the bench, but can't. Sakhlarantsev out front, and Iwata with the intercept, but putting a stick on that was Bondarenko, sending it up and over the net. Bondarenko off his skate. As the Giants are hemmed in, Long works it up to Conway, and George Iwata's finally going to get that change. Tyschenko has to be careful. He had Pekinich and Goodwin to deal with. Ihor Horbanov tucked in behind Šušek, and Horbanov with a terrible pass. It's going back to Conway. Conway fakes the shot. Goodwin to Conway. Back to Pekinich. Pekinich, a righty on the left, thought about shooting, sends it back across to Conway. And Tsitsura scampers down the left. Poprzej trying to put it back into the middle, and a block there by Swindlehurst. Poprzej bullies his way to the net. Poprzej in the backhand. Looked like a reach in there by Swindlehurst to make sure that puck didn't get towards the goal. And Nikita Lishnikov keeps it in, albeit momentarily. Swindlehurst gave it away to Serhii Tsitsura. Re-entry from Tsitsura. Swings out wide. Swindlehurst with a good poke check. Dvornik walks out front. Dvornik, what a stop by Dixon. He got the right pad out and across like a lightning bolt, or it would have been 7-5. Dixon with a couple of big saves in the last few shifts for the Giants. Now they have that three-goal lead. He wants to keep it as such. Pass up the middle. Dvornik nearly picked it off. Nikita Lishnikov sent all the way down to Boyko. Back to Lishnikov. 8:40 remaining in the third period. Don't forget BelfastGiants.com/donate. Hockey Can't Stop Tour. Donate now. Here's Boyko. Boyko trying to dance through the middle of the ice. Cooper will take over. Pass too far for Garside. The 16-year-old Ilya Sherbak, who has a goal tonight for Dnipro. Olenek played it back. Here's Grant Cooper looking for the hat trick, perhaps. Cooper rims it around. Grant Cooper to Mark Cooper. Mark Cooper muscles his way into the corner. Saviano. Saviano's had a good game as well. Former standout in the SHL and the Finnish Liga. And, of course, a standout with the Giants. You know what? Mark Cooper thought about the Michigan right there. He was thinking about it. And coming right into his space was Portnoy saying, no, 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 not on my watch. Here's Olenek. Sherbak. Kel Beattie. Good line by Beattie. Good layers as well as he's helped out. Cooper. Garside came back to help out the youngster Beattie. Vasiliev. 7.5 remaining. Giants All-Stars 7, Dnipro Kherson 4. Sahlaradze back to Vasiliev and blockered away by Dixon. Baum reaching in on Bondarenko. Baum to McLeod, gives it away. Sahlaradze away from Beattie. Stewart. Max Stewart had his stick lifted by Sahlaradze and Tyschenko trying to walk out front. Giants collapsing to try and help out. Long shift from McLeod and company, though. Here's Beattie. Kel Beattie on Vasiliev. McLeod will finally find some room, and the Giants will get a respite. Here's Baum. Line change coming. Baum to Eriksson. Eriksson thought about shooting. It just rolled on him at the last second. Here's Henrik Eriksson. Trying to beat two guys in the corner. Tyschenko getting in the way. Tyschenko. Sahlaradze out wide to Bondarenko. Bondarenko trying to cut back on McLeod. McLeod's had about a 3-minute shift here. Sahlaradze into the corner. Plays it back. Pankov. Pankov with a nice move. Pankov into a shooting position. And again, Andrew Dixon shuts the door.
Yeah, a long period of play there. You hardly got a break. Murph and Andrew Dixon come up with a couple of big saves. And Dnipro are certainly, they're not sitting back. They want to try and get this next goal in the game, and you never know, maybe put a goalie and try and get it back within one. So there's still a lot to play for. Great to see again everybody enjoying themselves and getting a few texts and messages coming through here saying how many people at home watching enjoying themselves as well.
Well, there's at least what, 5,500, 6,000 in the building this evening. Hopefully there's plenty online. Hopefully there's plenty of people donating, because that's what it's all about. Here's Baum. Thanks to anyone tuning in. Thanks to anyone donating this evening. Ticket sales going to the cause. Here's a redirect in front by Bass. Think about it. We've got this wonderful facility here. I mean, it's not even worth thinking about if this facility was damaged somehow and you couldn't bring the community together. So money raised this evening, and events like this will help, hopefully, to get people back on the ice, back in the Ukraine, get leagues back up and running, get players doing what they love, which is play the sport we all love, hockey.
No, you're absolutely right. It'd be absolute devastation. I'm sure these, especially the young players as well, you know, when you miss out of an important couple of years, 15, 16, 17 years of age, it's really difficult to get those years back as a player. So, you know, hopefully they can start to raise some more money and we can help out there with the donation we're making tonight, which should be fantastic.
Awada. For long, nearly too many men on the ice there, but we know the referees won't call anything. As we get down to inside, 5 minutes remaining. At SSE Arena, Conway shot, skipped into the corner, and now it's Pickenich. Conway, great set of hands. Pankov intercepts, though, and works it on to Lisnikov. Lisnikov for Sherbak. Adam Keefe reaching for that. Adam Keefe throws the first hit of the game as Adam Keefe steps in to Lisnikov. So he's got a hit, a blocked shot, and a shot on goal. Adam Keefe doing a little bit of everything. He used to wearing a suit and tie behind the bench the last few seasons. Throwing a shoulder check. Goodwin with a shot. Goodwin under the left hand of Sushek, but he scrambles and keeps it off the line.
There's nobody playing defense here.
Seholorodtsev, 2-on-0. Seholorodtsev. Bondarenko will finish it off. They went tick-tack, tick-tack, tick-tack-toe, and Bondarenko makes it 7-5.
They're back within two. A 2-on-0. There was certainly no defense from the Belfast Giants All-Stars on that occasion. Andre Dixon, no chance on that. And they're calling for a review here. They're calling for a review at the other end. David Goodwin coming onto the ice, and Andre Dalton not paying any attention to him.
David Goodwin, the captain.
He wants a goal tonight. They all want to get a goal.
What a leader he is. He got cut in the finals weekend and stitches by the right eye. Didn't miss a shift.
Wanted to get straight back out there again. It was about 7 or 8 minutes to go in the first period. He got stitched up at the end of the first period. They just sort of covered it up with the steri strips, and thankfully he was able to get back on. And that game on Sunday, the Giants didn't really play particularly well in the first period. I thought the Devils did really, really well. You know, they limited the chances for Belfast, but when the Giants got that first goal in the second period from Jeff Baum, to be very honest, I knew it was only going to be one winner. I thought they really stepped it up in the third, coming up with some big goals. Steve Ari's finish for the game winner, and Donny Niles coming off the bench for the third, and an empty netter by Mark Cooper, and coming up with a grand slam. It's just fantastic, absolutely fantastic.
You're right, that Ori goal really, it felt like there was no way back. Even at 2-1, it just felt like it was done. Here's Bondarenko, another 2-on-1 situation. Bondarenko, good stick by Swindlehurst as the pass was intended back for Seholorodtsev. Here's Goodwin. Goodwin. Pickenich. Oh, he's robbed. The left hand of Nazeri Sushek.
Again, those three just combine it really, really well. JJ Pickenich tries to go top shelf, and Sushek coming up with another big goal. Big save, my apologies. It's great to see everybody on the ice playing with a smile on their face. And that's on both sides of the red line. You know, it's fantastic to see that everybody having a good night. And again, another huge save by Sushek.
Saviano, that's a set play. They really want to get one here. Face-off play, and Saviano, that's a lovely save by Nazeri Sushek. Dvornik versus Cooper. Good face-off win to Pankov. 3:20 remaining in the contest. Dvornik was intended for him, but here comes Saviano. Saviano to Grant Cooper, back to Saviano, and another glove save by Sushek as Saviano tried to put it up and over him. And Nazeri Sushek has played very well for Dnipro Kherson. Garsai, Saviano, good quick movement of the puck here. Saviano looks like he hasn't missed a beat since leaving the Giants. Here's Garsai. Garsai to Cooper, showtime, Mark Cooper on the board, 8-5.
Mark Cooper with his fourth point of the night. He's already picked up three apples, and he gets on the score sheet in the goal column.
This is just a piece of magic. It's Grant Cooper off the wall to Garsai. Well, Garsai, you forget, you talk about his offensive upside. He slides it along, and Mark Cooper with a nice little trick play through the legs. And with 2:49 remaining, a three-goal lead for the Giants All-Stars. Goal and three assists, you said. 4 points for Mark Cooper. Lishnikov. Out front and all alone is Ravuka, and Ravuka has his second of the game, 8-6.
Another great finish, and he goes over to take the applause of everybody in the away section. The Ukraine fans all on their feet. Another great finish, and again another quick goal. Still 2:40 left in this game.
Anatoly Ravuka, just 17 years of age, a pair of tallies this evening for Dnipro Kherson. Lishnikov bodies out on Stewart. Back the other way comes Eriksson. Eriksson up and over the goal. Sushek watched it sail away. Here's Lisnikov into the middle of the ice. A giveaway by Tsitsura. Here's Olenek. Here's Garside. Garside with a couple of assists this evening. McLeod nearly turned it over. He does turn it over. Rivka trying to get it out front for his hat trick, but it's covered up with 2 minutes exactly remaining on the clock as Dixon will have a face-off. Let us know where you're watching from this evening, folks. At Murph on Ice, at Kitchy16, I believe, is yours. We've appreciated your company. The last game at SSE Arena in what has been a magical season and hopefully a magical amount of money being raised for the Ukraine hockey dream. Sahalarotsev, Tyschenko. Couldn't keep the puck in. Here comes Kieran Long, 2-on-1 with Lloyd. Long trying to get it back to Lloyd. Going down on his belly was Vasiliev, the captain, with a good defensive stick. And you know now everyone in Teal would love to get Darryl Lloyd a goal. Sahalarotsev had that puck sail away from him. Bomb. Bondarenko. Boxel trying to get there ahead of Tyschenko. Bomb. A-frames over the puck. Sahalarotsev have spent a lot of time in the offensive zone this evening. He's going to be a tired player. Here's Lloyd to Long. Boxel with the one-timer. Right pad saved by Sushak. As Boxel tried to go low. Here's Bast. Bast holds on. Bast trying to get it out front to Long. Here's Darryl Lloyd. Lloyd to Baum inside a minute remaining. Baum in front, redirected by Bast. Rebound too far for Long. Vasiliev for Sahalarotsev. And once again, he's in all alone. We saw 2-on-0 with him and Bondarenko earlier in the period. Sahalarotsev, backdoor play. Tyschenko was stick-checked by Goodwin. 35 seconds remaining in the contest. Goodwin to the line, no further. Goodwin stays with it, as does Baum. Baum couldn't get the puck out. Tyschenko, it's bobbling around in there. And final shot from Dvornik is gobbled up by Dixon. He was in trouble. The puck was all around the goal mouth with the 6-on-5 as the goalie. Sushek had just gotten to the bench for the extra attacker.
This has been a great night. It really has. It's been fantastic to be able to call the game with yourself, Murph, and again, with no stress. Nothing on the... Oh, they're calling a timeout. Here they are. They want to get this goal and take a timeout and try and rest up the top line that they have going. But, you know, seeing so many people in the arena, seeing so many Ukraine flags and watching a lot of people watching at home as well, it's a great endless season.
Well, think about it. I mean, Vitas Lukasevicius, a Lithuanian, former Lithuanian under-20 international, a good buddy of ours. I played against him in the old Irish Ice Hockey League. Now he's a linesman. He's donating his time tonight. No doubt he's made a donation online as well. You and I are here because we enjoy each other's company. We do the Friendship 4. We played together. But it's the hockey community, doesn't matter where you're from, Canada, Northern Ireland, Lithuania, that's just a little triangle in our small group, in our part of the hockey world. And look at everyone in this building. There's so many great stories being told here this evening.
And we also have now, on January 24, the Friendship Series between Princeton and Providence women who are coming in to play in Belfast. I think it's the 5th and 6th of January. And we've got that to look forward to as well.
Well, you can count me in, Mr. Kitchen. I will join you if the call comes in. Well, there's an empty net for Saviano. Saviano for Lloyd. And Lloyd, a fan favorite around these parts, a physical character, a line mate of Adam Keefe. And on his return for one night only, Lloydie tucks home the night.
Darryl Lloyd played 5 years in Belfast. His stats over the years, 289 games, 75 goals, 94 assists, 169 points. And for him to come up with a big goal like that, I'm sure he'd be pleased. And
they come right back. Setsura with a bit of showtime, and it's tucked home by Pope Rajai.
Adam Keefe shouting at Darryl Lloyd, not covering his man.
Kiefer giving Lloyd, he's all happy with his goal, and Kiefer saying, yeah, but you got to take your man coming back. Well, fair dues to Dmitry Poprzyj. He's actually been very good this evening. He'll tuck one home, and it's 9-7 with 4.5 seconds remaining on the clock. And as you said, Simon, it's been a magical evening. And we will hear from our good buddy Robert Fitzpatrick in just a few moments' time about the results of this evening's fundraising efforts. A 9-7 final as the clock hits 60 minutes. Adam Keefe and Vasiliev, the two grizzled veterans, meeting at center ice to congratulate each other. Andrew Dixon, surrounded by his teammates, Petr Cech started the game. And at the other end, Sushek and Salyutin played well in the goals as well. But it wasn't about who would win or what the stats would be. It's a 9-7 final in favor of the Giants All-Stars. I think in weeks, months, years to come, no one will remember the score, but we'll always remember the charitable efforts and the atmosphere here, the friendships gained between Dnipro Kherson and the Giants All-Stars. And to all of you watching at home and donating and trying to help out the Ukraine hockey dream.
Absolutely. You know, it's fantastic to have. It's actually fantastic to be here tonight. There's so many positives that are going to come out of this game tonight. And one of the things that I'm sort of feeling a wee bit sentimental about is it's the last time that we're going to get to see some of these guys on the ice here at the SSC Arena, especially from the team from this year, winning the Grand Slam. You look at Scott Conway, David Goodwin, Mark Cooper, Grant Cooper, all these guys that, you know, they may be getting offers next year. And when you're successful, everybody wants your good players, and that's not going to be any different this year as well. We're going to have a tough job holding on to all these guys, and you know, it's a really sentimental moment for me, to be honest. I think it's fantastic to have all these wonderful players here tonight. There's the Ukrainians all coming down right to the glass to take the plaudits for their team that have come here this evening, and they've shown up in numbers. There's over 250 fans here this evening as well. It's just great to see.
Down below us, a Ray Sawada Giants jersey and a Ray Sawada Dallas Stars jersey. 12 minutes in, we pay tribute. All 6,000 on their feet here paying tribute to Ray Sawada. The number 12 of Ray Sawada is also on all three of those trophies from the treble, the Challenge Cup, the league, and the playoff trophy. And just an evening for friendships, an evening for hockey. And as our good friend Davey Majimsey said to me at the Motor Point Arena in Nottingham, you know, if there's someone you care about in hockey or in life, tell them. So on that note, this evening, with money being raised for the Ukraine, if there's someone that you should check in on, make sure you do. Hockey, life, so important for those friendships. And look at the reception for Dnipro Kherson. And that's what I'm talking about, the friendships that'll be forged for this one trip here from this Ukrainian hockey team. The memories will last forever.
Not many people know they travel for 36 hours to get here. 36 solid hours to get here. The long journey on a train in the Ukraine, then they flew to Luton, then they flew to Belfast, and it's been a tough journey for them. They only came in yesterday afternoon. They played the game tonight. They travel home tomorrow. It's a speed gap tour, and it's just fantastic to be part of this tonight.
Hand down to Deputy Dave McCammon, the PA addresser here at SSC Arena.
Just one thing, Sarah Stanton, who's going to be doing the Man of the Match awards here this evening. Sarah is the owner of Cara Travel, who played a phenomenal effort to get this team here tonight. She paid from her company for all the flights for the Ukraine team to come here tonight. And it's a wonderful gesture from Sarah. Fantastic support. She's been a great supporter of the Belfast Giants, the friendship for over the years as well. And we couldn't do it without her. Mark Cooper, one goal, three assists here this evening, and he's going over to take the plaudits.
Is he getting the same bottle of gin you gave to me earlier, Sis?
He's getting another one.
It's the only time I can ever say I got the same award as
Absolutely.
Mark Cooper.
You got the Malamas tonight, <statement. laughs> Absolutely.
Coop is just a class act, isn't he? Can play up and down the lineup, first line, second line, doesn't matter. Defensively responsible. Always with that big grin on his face, loves his hockey.
Martin McDonald is going to present a commemorative memento to George James Simcoe, the president of Please welcome the CEO of the Odyssey Trust, Robert Fitzpatrick.
Hello. Just to say a few words at the end of what has been an incredible season, where the Belfast Giants have finally done what we always thought we could do, never quite got there until this year. This magnificent team have delivered you the treble. There's just a couple of things that I want to say. It's been a great year, and winning the treble has been unbelievably superb and beyond my wildest dreams. But I think you will all agree, tonight is what the Belfast Giants are about. It is right and fitting that we use our sport to help people. And the way that the game came about, the work that was done, you're going to see in a couple of minutes just exactly what it is you've achieved and what it will mean to this team. But just before I do that, there's a couple of people I want to mention. I want you all to be upstanding to a man who was asked to play on Sunday and got here today, and that's Petr Cech. This team have been and have taken us all on an amazing journey. So one last time, please be upstanding for the team that has brought the Belfast Giants to Grand Slam. Your Belfast Giants. Okay. We said when we had the opportunity to put a hand of friendship out that we would try and help. And if I could ask two of my colleagues, Clark Cosgrave and James Glover, to join me on the mat, Georgie maybe would come out as well. Through your generosity and through your unbelievable kindness, the Odyssey Trust are in the position tonight to make an award to our Ukrainian friends of £50,000. Last but not least, it would be remiss of me not to acknowledge the work of three men who were central to all of our success this year, three men whose work tomorrow starts all over again. Please put your hands together for Rob Stewart, George Awada, and your head coach, Adam Keefe. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, fans of the Belfast Giants, we are nothing without you. You are our heartbeat. Always continue to be so. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Robert Fitzpatrick. Okay, then, of course, you can still donate if you want to. That link is still, please share among your friends and family, BelfastGiants.com/today. But as our teams make their way from the ice, let's raise the roof tonight in Belfast. Let's hear it for both our teams. Let's hear it for Dnipro Kherson and the Belfast Giants All-Stars.
Well, a magical evening wrapping up at SSE Arena. 9-7 final in favor of the Giants All-Stars over Dnipro Kherson. But it's about the friendships and the memories made this evening in beautiful Belfast. BelfastGiants.com/donate to help out. You can help with the Ukraine hockey dream, the Hockey Can't Stop Tour. I'm Aaron Murphy as the teams assemble for the Causeway Clap. For Simon Kitchen and the entire crew, thanks for joining us this evening. It's been a pleasure. We'll see you down the road. Keep your head up and your stick on the ice. Goodbye for now. I'm Aaron Murphy.